Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show. In case you're joining us, this show airs weekdays at Thursdays at 10 p.m. And the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 in the morning. So make a date and learn something about how you can improve your business. Let's talk you through how to make money. And when COVID happened and the lockdown was announced, she saw an opportunity of how she could start up something around her home. And now it's a budding business. She makes her money. Good enough, she uses social media for marketing, and she says if given any other choice, she would still choose the same, the flower business. This is how to make money.
Hi everyone, my name is Riba Divine Lynn. I am the CEO and founder of Happy Petals Uganda. I deal in indoor plants, outdoor plants, compound designing, interior designing, landscaping, seeds, pots, a variety of anything as long as it is concerning plants. We have a variety of plants ranging from indoor, outdoor. If you want landscaping plants, if you want grass, we have a variety of things really. I am located in Chanja. I am still a small business, so I basically work from home and do most of my work is actually online. So what I do, I create something nice, I put it online. If somebody likes it, we make a delivery to them, to their destinations. And if you want me to do a site visit, probably you want us to do some landscaping, compound designing. I began this business in lockdown 2021. We were stuck in lockdown. They chased me from my former job. I was among the people that didn't survive, actually. So I bought plants, house plants, from a friend of mine called Leticia. And the peace that the plants gave me was just different. Honestly, it was just different. It just compelled me to just want to get more plants. So the more plants I got, the more peaceful I became. And then when I found out that different plants have different benefits, I wanted to explore. When I started exploring, I didn't want to stop, and that's how I am here right now. I didn't begin with much, honestly. I actually didn't begin with a lot of money. What I did at the beginning, I knew I wouldn't have the capital, so I was smart enough to think outside the box. I asked my clients, who are mainly my friends, by the way, at that particular point. I asked the clients, if you could pay 50%, I use the 50% as capital, and once I'm done with the product, you add the 50%. That's how it all came together. I didn't even have to look for money anywhere or get a loan or, you know, get out of my comfort zone. It was basically me thinking outside the box, that's all. First of all, you need to do your research. You can't just come. Everyone says that. You need to do your research about something before you go into it. And also, to me, this is no longer a job. It's a passion. This is what I do. I love doing this. This is literally the thing that I enjoy doing the most. A friend of mine asked me some time back when I retire, what do I want to be? I told him I want to be in a greenhouse. And that's my dream. If I get my big greenhouse and I'm doing different projects, I'm helping people have better health benefits, that'll be it. I'll be done. Actually, I'm planning to retire at 30. So in case you need me after 30, I don't know. I don't think I'll be here. Yeah. The first biggest challenge, actually, delivery. Yeah, we have delivery issues. I used to have a car, but then you know how life just goes. We used to deliver with the car. I'll deliver the things myself, and I was really extremely careful. But with time, of course, we get issues as people, as normal people. So I use border guys to make the deliveries. But if I don't know a specific border guy and I've not prepped them on how to take care of the plant before it reaches the client, it's going to reach when it's already in pieces. So I have that issue of delivery, but I'm working on it. By the grace of God, it's going to get better. The second issue is a lot of new plant parents don't know how to take care of the plants. So you give them something that is nice, perfectly well done. They reach back at home. They don't know how to take care of it. The plant ends up drying, and then they start saying, oh, you gave me something fake or what. But I give you instructions on how to take care of your baby, because once you buy a plant, that is your responsibility. You become a parent. That is your responsibility. So if you're not responsible for your plant, it's going to be hard for you to take care of it. And that's just the honest truth. I hope people don't get it out of proportion in the later on future. And I think those are like the biggest challenges I have so far. It's just transportation means and yeah, careless plant parents. But now before someone takes a plant, I make sure that I've prepped them enough for this, like really, really enough for this. So that's also a problem that is not going to be there anymore. Yeah. As I told you earlier, this is now my passion. It's no longer anything concerning me just selling plants or pots. Actually, the other thing that I've gotten out of it, I used to love art back then as a kid, but then my mom said it wasn't okay for me to offer art in high school, so I had to drop it. But now I get to express all my feelings in these vases. I create things from my head the way I want it to come out, and it does come out. And people are buying all my beautiful creations. And these are all ideas that came from my head because this is what I loved doing back then. I also have a couple of art pieces in my house, but I've gotten perfect because I do most of the practice on the vases. So, yeah, I think it's the art out of it and the creativity that comes with it. I did some classes as well. Of course, I didn't just go there. I did some classes as well on content creation, social media content creation. And I've seen a lot of growth. I've really seen a lot of growth. And I can tell you, you can actually see from my page that I put in a lot of work. And I care about what I put out there. I really do, because I want to give people the best quality of what I can afford. So social media is actually a very good platform, and it's really, really helpful. In case you want to grow your business out there, please do not take social media for granted. You never know which person wants what, and they do not have the energy to just be moving around in markets. So you can sell these things online. Don't sit down when it comes to social media. Just don't. I think I'm one of the cheapest plant people ever. We have different vases. I'm going to just put some here, some few designs that you could see. We have some big pots down here as well, but my plants start from, this is 5,000. I have from 10,000, 12,000, 15,000, 20,000, even 17. Actually, you can come and bargain. It's okay, just come again. You can even tell me your budget. I can get you something according to your budget. I have clay pots, I have plastic pots, I have glass bottles. Actually, the other thing, we also do recycling, and I really believe in recycling as much. So if you have alcohol bottles at home or wine bottles just sitting, you could do something nice for you. Or even, this was a Minute Maid bottle. Minute Maid, the big Minute Maid, the mango bottle. This now is a hanging plant. Imagine anything that is out there that can be created to hold life and bring more health benefits to a person. I am down for it. I always do that. Yeah. There are a lot of health benefits of having plants. Do you know how many toxic kinds of, what should I call it? There's a lot of toxic air in the places that we be in the spaces that we live in, especially for living in the cities. There's a lot of toxins everywhere, but these plants absorb all those kinds of toxins that could literally make you sick in the future. So it's better to have a greenhouse now than start treating cancer later on in the future and you're suffering, you don't have money. Yet these things could literally be prevented. Another thing, we could get herbs, you could get spices and just have them at home in your garden instead of buying every single day. You just have them inside at your home. When you want to take rosemary tea, you just go to your garden, pick your rosemary and we do all these things. So if you want us to do a small garden for you at home that is basically to help you or help your health, I can recommend a couple of plants that can literally help you with that. We also have different plants that come with different benefits. We have the money plant if you're looking for money. You have the lucky bamboo if you're looking for luck. We have the peace lily. If you want peace at home, we have the peace lily. There is a variety of anything. And also if you're just into aesthetics or interior designing, I'm still the perfect person for that. Do not wait on a man to come and help you out. If you're not smart enough, if you cannot pick yourself outside whatsoever situation you're in at that particular point, then it's not going to be easy for you. So don't sit down and think something is just going to magically happen. You're supposed to be thinking, be creative. Make sure you go to all those corners that you feel that your body tells you that you can't. Yeah, be fearless. Just be fearless. That's all I can say. And if you have an idea, go for it. Thank you.
So Reba Divine Lynn is an entrepreneur focusing on plants and flowers flowers as well. Yeah. So I keep saying on the show that it's important for you to venture into a business that you love, because then it is out of that that all your passion will be felt and the actual reason you started the business will be also met. But if you're just going to do something because you have money, you'll start questioning yourself just how much more or how longer you can actually stay in that business. So it's important that you venture into something that you love, do that market research, do people around you need the services, and every opportunity for you as a business person should be really embraced. That's how to make money for this week. Let's talk you through personal finance. And after the budget reading, we know that you are probably now realigning your decisions and saying, where do I go from here? I can't continue working for people and I need to start my business. The question is, what type of financing are you looking at? Is it money that you are borrowing from a bank, a SACCO, anything like that? Or you have been saving, you know, for you to have this business started? This week, we talked to the CEO of Made Business Consult, who talks to us about why we need funding for our business ventures. That and more in our personal finance tips for this week. Welcome to yet another episode of our business show tonight. And this evening, we're going to talk about on various ways of how you can get funding or finances for your business or businesses. You will have an idea for a business, and probably you are thinking of setting up a business, and you don't know where and how to get finances. When you have an idea, and you conceptualize the idea, and you want to begin a business, the next step is to mobilize resources or to raise funds. And this is where it's important that we discuss this very important topic of how to get funds or finance for your business. I would like to address two key issues of how you as a business owner or somebody who is starting a business, how you can get financing. First of all, we have what we call personal finances and then what we call debt financing. But first, before we go further to understand and know why where we should get this funding, it's important to know the various needs or why we need to get funding. Usually, you might want funding to start your business, for example, if it's a startup. Secondly, you may also need finances for your business to improve your cash flow of the business. Thirdly, you might also want finances to increase on your capital investments of your business, maybe to buy more machinery, to build more, to make more structures for the building, to buy raw materials and the like. And then also, you might need business finances when you are involved in a lengthy a product cycle. For example, if you are putting together a prototype, something that you want to test in the market. So those are some of the various reasons why you may need financing. So what are the various alternatives to financing? We've talked of personal financing, and we also talked about debt financing. Now, with personal financing, this is financing which involves getting funds from your personal savings and also from your family and friends. The family and friends can be a very good source of your financing. Then also, we also have equity capital. Equity capital is where we have an external investor willing to exchange for shares in order to invest in your business. And then also debt financing. We shall also discuss along the way the various creative sources of funding.
Now, to exactly explain the other ways of how you can raise personal finances and coming up with a creative way of raising these finances is what we normally call bootstrapping. Bootstrapping is one way of avoiding external funding and coming up with creative and ingenious and thrift ways of how you can access finances. What are some of these ways of bootstrapping? One, we can look at, for example, in case you want to invest in machinery for your organization or business, instead of buying new machines, why not buying used machines, which are cheaper? So here, you'll be able to save some of the money. Then also, when it comes to alternative sources of buying raw materials, it's very, very important that you look around to see where you can get cheaper options, maybe on the internet, maybe moving around, asking around for some of the prices. You'll be able to, you'll be amazed on how sometimes you can easily acquire these materials or products at a cheaper price, which will help you to invest in your businesses. The other issue also we need to look at is the option of going to for leasing. Leasing is where you are given an asset or equipment for use and you pay the owner of the lease, you pay periodically. So this does not stretch your finances, and here you're able to invest in your business. Then another frugal way on how you can source some funds and set up some funds for your business is minimizing your expenses. This is one way of how you can cut costs, be frugal, and save money for your businesses.
So there you have it. In as much as you want to start a business, you would want to think that borrowing to start a business might be risky depending on how you have ascertained the possible outcomes of the market. But if you're sure that what you're venturing into is probably needed and you're going to make your money back real time quick, then you might just take that loan and start your business. Remember, borrowing is not bad. What's bad is if you borrow and you misuse the money. So we have a whole month-long series for personal finance, and we'll be talking different topics to help you improve your personal finance. So you have every reason to stay with us and learn how you can manage your personal finances. Good stuff. Let's talk you then through the Forex and money market report for this week. The shilling has been at about 3.68-ish, yeah, depending on where you transact from. Let's just have a look at the comprehensive report now. Well, I guess I have to go now. Thank you so much for making time. Feel free to get in touch with us in the meantime and after the program. The conversation continues on our social media handles. Tell us what you think about the show, how your business is faring across. And also, if there's anything you feel you need to be talked to about on how you can improve your business, we're right here at Vision Group to help you handle that. Friday, tomorrow, yes. So for you that will be watching this, it will be a repeat on Saturday, but on Friday, remember, the Bride and Groom Expo starts down at the Uma Showground. So you have every reason to go down there looking to get married or marry. Yes, go down and set out some plans for your marriage and see where you can go for your destination for honeymoon and any other thing that could help you with your marriage. Give them the treat, and we're here as Vision Group and partners to have that delivered to you. Until then, you take care of yourselves. My name is Simon. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.